Hi, I'm Jamie Kitchen, training manager at Danfoss. In this video, we're going to show how to navigate the extended wizard parameter menu. And we're going to do an example where we're going to adjust the compressor delay time at startup, the evaporator fan startup delay after defrost, and we're going to set the minimum off and on compressor run times. Once the desired program and room set point have been selected, it may be necessary to customize many of the parameter values found in programs such as defrost, minimum compressor runtime, preferred units, et cetera, et cetera. You can do this by accessing the extended wizard parameter menu, and you would access this once the controller is operating after initial startup or maybe during a service call if some parameters need to be changed to improve system performance. Now, in video three, we selected a program that controls the liquid line solenoid valve to control the operation of the compressor directly through the low pressure control. We selected a space temperature of minus 10 degrees Fahrenheit with temperature terminated defrost. So now let's use this same program and dive a little deeper into the different parameters. Shown is the pathway for moving through and selected values in the extended wizard parameter menu. It works on parameter levels, with level one being a process such as defrost, alarms, or regulation and control, while level two parameters will be in the level one group. So setting the maximum defrost duration would be a level two parameter in the level one defrost group. The value of the level two parameter, say 40 minutes for maximum defrost duration, is a level three parameter. And this will be what you ultimately select and set. Now, once you have hit set, the controller will go back to the level two parameter menu. Trust me, this sounds way more complicated than it really is. You can access the extended wizard parameter menu by pressing set on the controller for 6 seconds. This will take you to the level one menu and RE will be displayed. From there, press the up and down buttons to scroll to the level one parameter you want and hit set. Then use the up down buttons once again to scroll to the level two parameter you want to select a value for and hit set. These level three values can be scrolled through until the correct one is shown. Hit set and you will go back to the level two values. In this example, we will set post defrost compressor start to 2 minutes, and this will allow for condensate drainage. The default value is 1 minute. Set post fan delay to 3 minutes after the defrosting terminates to allow for coil pull down. This will give a 1 minute post compressor start. Default is 2 minutes. Set minimum on and off time to 10 minutes. The default is zero. On the extended wizard parameter menu, we will need to go to level one parameter DEF and then scroll and select D9. So using the controller, press set for 6 seconds, and you will go into the level one parameters. When you see RE, scroll up until you see DEF and hit set. From there, we need to go up and scroll till we see D9. So D9, hit set, and then you'll see the default value of 1 minute. Increase that to 2 minutes, hit set, and then press the escape button here. When you hit escape, you will go back to the level one parameter menu. Now from here, we will need to go to the level one parameter fan and select F4. So let's scroll to the level one parameter fan and hit set. Now from there, we will need to scroll until we see F4, which is a parameter we will need to modify to change the fan delay after defrosting. So there's F4, and you can see the default value is 2. So let's change that to 3, hit set, and we're back to the level 2 parameter. Finally, to set the minimum off and on time for the compressors, we will need to scroll back to RE and hit set. From there, we will scroll to C4, hit set, and then select one so that we apply the next values to both the minimum off and on runtime of the compressor. Once we've done that, we scroll to the actual value itself, C5. Hit set. And since we selected 10 minutes, we need to scroll to 10 and hit set. Once we've done that, hit escape twice, and we go back to the temperature control menu. Congratulations, we are done. We have set all three parameters that we set out to do in our example.
Thank you for watching our video. For more information on the Danfoss Optima controller, please visit the link in the description below.